Hey there, I'm Trevor Houston, the creator of the Who You Know Summit, and I'd like to welcome you to the Who You Know Job Networking Show.
On our program, we'd like to show you the job search like you've never seen.
Everything from getting noticed by employers, how to properly format your resume, and how to network effectively using LinkedIn to drive recruiters to your profile.
We even take suggestions from our amazing community.
So if you want to learn all things job search, go ahead and subscribe now.
Focus. It's all about the job search. So if you want to learn how to land that next success, you heard them. All you got to do is subscribe and ring that bell so you don't miss out on a thing.
Welcome back to the Who You Know Job Networking Show, where what you know is important, but
who you know.
Who you know.
Who you know. Who you know. That makes the difference in your job search for sure.
It definitely can. You know what I was just thinking? Who you know, who you know, who you know. No. No, it's Christmas. Come on, y'all. Come on, son. All right. Well, let me tell you who I know. I know this very special guy. His name is Liam Hubbard, and he started at Hirect after being frustrated with the job-seeking process. How many of y'all are frustrated with the job-seeking process?
Ooh, Lord.
Well, he was too, and he wanted to be in a position to change that process for not only himself but for others. So if everybody can welcome Liam Hubbard.
Hi, Liam. Thank you for joining us.
Hey, guys. Thanks for having me on. I'm very excited.
Yay, Tennessee.
Man, we're pumped up, man. So I'm excited you're here. We're talking all about technology for job seekers, right? Mm-hmm. How can we use tools and technology to humanize the job search process to help us get in front of the people that we need to get in front of? So talk to us about... Well, actually, before we get into Hirect, you said in your bio that you were frustrated. You were a frustrated job seeker. What was so frustrating for you? What was the experience like for you when you were searching?
Yeah, definitely. I think everyone's probably run into the frustrations of, you know, applying for a job and not hearing anything back ever. But I think personally, what's even more frustrating to me is to get through, you know, 2 to 3, sometimes even 4 or 5 interviews only to be ghosted or, you know, hear nothing for a month or two. I think that that's horrible. I hate leading people on. I hate being led on. So that's a big frustration of mine. In my own job search, I would be so excited about these companies. I was like, oh, you know, 3 rounds in, there's no way I wouldn't get this. And then, you know, you get the fun email that says, you know, we've gone with another candidate, or we've, you know, reimagined the role. I'm not really sure what that one means, but I did get that one a few times.
What was that? What did it say?
Reimagining the role.
The company's reimagining the role. Okay, gotcha.
That's what they say.
Yeah,
so,
okay.
I don't know if it's just a gentle way of being let down, but that was my experience. You know, I was in a position, the start of 2021, I was in a job that I did not like. I dreaded going to work every day. It was kind of a bad situation with bad management. Just didn't know how to do anything there. Felt stuck. So, you know, the first time in my life I've ever done this, I resigned on the spot. And I made a promise to myself that the next job that I found was going to be one that I thoroughly enjoyed working at every single day, one that I was passionate about, and one that was able to help others, you know, because I wanted to make a difference. I want to be someone that can be a resource for people, someone that's improving the lives of others. I think that's so important. So, you know, the company that I'm at now, Hirect, they align with those values. They practice what they preach. And it's just, you know, it's such a life. It's just such a better experience.
Hold on.
I was going to ask too, Liam, like, so when you got that, we're reimagining the role, did you send them back that, hey, that's great, 'cause I'm imagining myself in that role?
Wow.
Wasn't that bold? I should have done more of that, but those were always the fun emails to get, but I did respect those more than the complete ghosts.
I want to recognize you real quick. Okay, I want to recognize you because for just a second. Because, okay, George, love George, he was on here just a second ago, right? George is the founder of Loop CV, right? Mm-hmm. So he found a problem, he went out to solve it. You know, your situation is a little different in the fact that you're not the founder of Hirect, But you were so like distraught about the job search process that he's like, I want to make an impact. Like, I want to go work for a company that can help solve this problem. And so now you're working for Hirect, which is super cool. So I just want to commend you for that, because some people would just go get a job anywhere, you know?
Oh, can I throw some dirt?
Throw some dirt. Let's see, let's hear the dirt.
So I'm a recruiter. So you recruiters, guys, here's the deal. We can't. There's no way in the world we can get back with everybody that sends a resume in. But you know what? If you interview someone, especially, you know, pre-COVID, we went in and did all the stuff. But if you take somebody's time to interview them, come on now. If they weren't hired, I know we don't like to give bad, you know, bad news, but job seekers need to know where they stand in the process. Liam just said it. He went in for a couple of two, three interviews, and he had an old lame thing. No. Come on, guys. We can pick up the phone, and we can call and say, Liam, it didn't work out. And you don't have to go into the details, because a lot of times you don't want to do that because you're dealing with other people. And I've been a recruiter for a long time. Guys, call them and tell them what's up.
And I get that. I would say I totally get what you're saying. And I would agree with that. I think that there's a huge problem going on right now. And the problem is, and I love it and I hate it. The problem is the technology. The technology is making it a little more challenging. And let me paint a picture for you like this. Yeah. So you get a guy who's got a tool, which is great. We just heard about it. Loop CV, right? You get Loop CV, and that application, he's applying all over the place, right? And so you got to think of how many applications are going out. How many applications are going out? So it would be impossible to get actual feedback on every one of those applications. It's just not possible, right? So the technology is creating some of this issue. So it's like, it's just a challenge. The whole job search process is a challenge. It's really, really challenging. But let's talk about Hirect and how it solves that. Some of these problems.
Yeah.
Who is Hirect for, Liam? Is it for companies, job seekers, startups? Like, who is it for?
Yeah, so also, I just want to preface this by my dog tends to know when I'm on a meeting or a call. So he might try to make an appearance in the background. He likes to make some noise. So I do apologize if that does happen. But
That's cool.
He needs to find a job. Hirect is for everybody, in my opinion. You know, it's for the job seeker who, you know, might have been interviewing for 4 months and hasn't been able to find anything, and they're frustrated because they know their value. They know they can, you know, make an impact at any company they're at. Mm-hmm. Hirect is for recruiters at startups. You know, it's for anybody, large, small companies. You know, we've got all different sizes of companies on the app, and you know, everyone's finding success because, you know, we're using AI similar to, other services. But what we do differently, I think, is, you know, it's a closed process right within the app. You can video chat directly in the app. You can, you know, text right back and forth with the founders and CEOs, as well as the recruiters. You know, we're trying to cut out as much of the emailing as possible, because like you guys said, you know, that can get so impersonal. So kind of trying to bring the hiring process to the 21st century. You know, we've got an app for everything now. You can order your groceries on an app. You can, find a date on an app. So, you know, why shouldn't you be able to flip the hiring process on its head and find your next job on an app?
Mm. And that's what's happening, guys. Let me tell you right now. Here's what's going on. The job search, again, I said it before, it's all upside down and messed up. It's a mess. And COVID created the solutions. Like, COVID created all these companies like Hirect and Loop CV. They're going out and they're trying to actively solve this problem with technology. Tech companies, technology is the future. Data, analytics, all this stuff. So I love it. I love it. I love it. And you're trying to put the human element back in. So talk to us about what does it look like from the inside of the app. So I'm in the app. I'm a job seeker. It matches me with some jobs, right? And then what happens?
Exactly. So you get matched with the job, and then if a recruiter wants to reach out, they send it right in there, and you've got a chat box. You've got all of these integrations. You know, you can video chat with them directly in the app, so you can jump right in. There's no lag time between, we found your application, or we found your resume, and we'd like to schedule an interview. A lot of that time is cut out because it can all be done right in the app, right there on your phone. People are really enjoying that aspect of it.
So you said the recruiter can reach out. Can the job seeker reach out to the recruiter directly, or is it just the recruiter can reach out to the job seeker directly? Can it go both ways?
Right. So as far as I know right now, it is just the one way with recruiters being able to reach out, but that's definitely something that's on our roadmap to introduce.
Okay,
so
cool.
Sort of a, you know, two-way street there, because I know LinkedIn, places like that do a really good job of being, you know, you can do that outreach. So something that we definitely are going to implement.
Awesome.
What about ghosting, Liam? Like, that's a big problem that we're seeing and hearing in the job search market, right? Is that people, they're not getting feedback, which you just solved that, right? But what if a company is on the platform and they're ghosting?
Yeah, candidates? Great question.
Is there exactly. some kind of process around that?
Is there a penalty? Or you like, you kick them off the app? You're like, get off my app.
Right. So, you know, we don't have any penalties for that, but we just encourage, you know, we encourage a lot more transparency between companies and any of the candidates. So, you know, there's a lot less of a drop-off between candidates and those recruiters, because everything, you know, as it's done with video calls and chats, you know, we try to make sure everyone's timely with their responses. So, again, not something we have implemented at the time, but that's not a bad idea to introduce going forward.
Yeah, like maybe just a point system, you know, like if it happens so many times or whatever, you know, like...
Or even like that, a point system that... You can see, the end users can see and say, oh, this person's very, very
It's
active.
Like Uber.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
you get a rating.
Yeah.
Right? And if you fall below a certain rating, it's like, sorry, bye-bye. Yeah. I like that.
Yeah, or people just know. They're like, oh, well, they're probably not great.
Well, yeah, it also, it's a negative reflection on the company. So the company's not going to want you doing that. Think about that. Like if Coca-Cola's on there and they got one star, they're like, what? They're gonna fire you as the recruiter that's on the platform. They're like, no, you only got one star. What are you doing? You're making us look bad. So that's actually good. You need to. I'm just saying. Let's throw some ideas out there.
No, that's a great idea, and that's something else I wanted to touch on. You know, we value user feedback so much here. You know, there's been cases where I've seen someone submit a review or some feedback, and you know, we're able to make that change within 24 to 48 hours on the app.
Oh, dang!
We have a really responsive team. You know, that's all they do is they sit there and, you know, pay attention to what people are saying. And you know, if we can make it happen, we'll make it happen.
Wow, that's. You know, dang, yeah. 24. Hey, look, Liam, let me tell you something. I got a mobile app too, okay? It's like pulling teeth to get anything, because I got this third-party company that I deal with, okay? Again, side hustle, not the main hustle, okay? So so getting anything done when it's your side hustle is a little challenging when, you know, you got to deal with somebody else. I like that. He's like, 24, 48 hours, give me the feedback. Well, doop, 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 doop.
I know this was said in the promo, but how much does it cost?
Hirect is completely free.
Boom!
For job seekers.
$3.99?
Completely free for...
Woo!
Yeah. Free on both sides. So, you know...
Oh, on both sides. Hold on.
On both sides?
Let me get another
both
one.
Both sides.
Woo! Yeah. That one bounced out.
Wow. Okay, that's all I can say is wow. How about, like... opportunities? Are you guys, you know, because the jobs, you have to have the jobs in your platform, right? So
exactly.
How does that work? How are you finding those positions, and what does that process look like?
Yeah, so we're always trying to work with new companies, getting them on board. We've got a team that they focus on that. You know, they're focused always on finding new companies that fit the platform, that are in need of talent. You know, because we've got the talent on the app. We're always looking for more companies to join on. You know, I think there are so many people on that app that, you know, might not do well on traditional platforms. They might not, you know, perform as well there, but you know, these are really talented people who, you know, they're kind of untapped. You know, if you're a job that's looking for some talent, you know, there's some of the resumes, some of the things I've seen on our app just has blown me away. You know, people, and it's surprising to me that they already aren't employed. You know, I'm sure a lot of them are employed already, looking for something new. But you know, just the sheer quality of the candidates that are on our app is so impressive to me.
All right, so. Talk to us about, I saw somewhere it was tech. Is it just tech, or what other types of roles and positions? I mean, what else on there? I mean, if I'm not in the tech industry, like, am I kind of out, or should I still take a look at it?
You should definitely still take a look at it. While tech is our strong suit, that's definitely kind of who we, attracted to the product first. We don't discriminate as far as your industry goes. And even if your company's tiny, if you have, 1 to 2 people on your company right now, you get the same opportunities and the same chance as a company that might have 300 people. There's equal opportunity there for all of the companies and all of the applicants. And I think that that's a really cool thing that our platform provides. There's no premiums. You can't pay to be noticed more or anything like that.
That's fair. A good one.
Yeah. No premium. I'm excited that during this time that you guys are a good idea, because we've been doing the same thing in corporate America, using the same platform, traditional platforms, and in Dallas, and I know it's not just in Dallas because our network's all over the United States, companies are having a hard time finding what they're looking for, but the candidates are out there. It's kind of I don't even know how to explain it. COVID has messed everybody's thinking up.
Yeah, well, it's kind of like, think about this for a second. So social media, let's just talk about that. You got a disruptor. What was the disruptor? TikTok came, it was a massive disruptor, right? The hiring is messed up, and so we've got disruptors coming out. Like they're trying,
and it wasn't good before we had all.
They're actively. That's what I'm trying to say. Is like COVID. This is a blessing for job seekers. It is putting the power in your hands. The tides are shifting.
I'd agree with that.
And the power is being put in your hands. They're literally trying to put it in your hands, like where you could just have it, and it's like Uber. It's convenient and it's easy, and now you have the power to choose what company. Because why would I go with one company versus the other?
But we got to rehumanize this thing like Trevor talks about all the time. We have to make that effort to be different. We have to make that effort to get out there. Of course, I'm Mr. Networking, right? So get out, meet people, develop those relationships, guys. That's where the difference is made. That's where the added value is, and people will move to that.
Well, and Hirect is allowing people to chat directly. That's what I like.
Yeah.
So it's allowing for that two-way communication between the job seeker and the decision maker. So there's that two-way communication straight from the app, boom. So I do like it. Job seekers, I want you to go ahead, get this app, give me your feedback, because again, same thing I told Loop CV, I need feedback and I want your feedback, and I'm sure they want it too. Liam, you want their feedback?
Oh, all day. Would love everybody's feedback on it, positive or negative. We take all of it.
Yeah, there you go. And he said they'll switch it up if there's something you don't like. Mm-hmm. They'll get in there and they'll actively start trying to improve. It's the same thing with us. And okay, so I know, Liam, with our app, one of our challenges, okay, is that I've got something that's really neat in there. Okay, we pay a lot of money every month to have this tool in there, and it's basically like its own social feed, but I they're not using it. So shame on y'all job seekers, you're not using it. So it's like this challenge of getting people in, right? Imagine Facebook's an amazing tool, right? It can do everything. Facebook can do like literally everything, right? But imagine Facebook with no people in it. It's useless. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It doesn't do anything if there's nobody in it. So same kind of problem and issue right now. We have some cool features. We got some really awesome features in our mobile app. They're not using it. So it's getting people in, getting people to use it. Are there any tools inside of your app, or what do you need to start happening inside your app to really make it and kick the thing off to be a success? Is there anything like that? Any quirks or kinks, or what do you need first? Do you need job seekers, or do you need companies, or?
Yeah, we need companies. We always need companies.
Companies.
There's a good amount of companies on there now, but as you guys said, we are new in the United States here. We've only been going since April, so of course we're always looking for more companies to come on. On the job seeker side, we've got some really interesting ideas for 2022. We have some more kind of career coaching and career advice ideas that are just going to be able to benefit anybody looking for a job. We're trying to make it a one-stop shop. So within our app, you can get everything you need, all of the resources, and get hired in 24 24 hours because we've had that happen more times than I
Oh, snap.
In 24 hours.
In 24 hours. Well, and that's another thing, too. I see report of acceleration of the hiring process up to 10 times faster. So that's what you guys are reporting. Now, where are you coming up with that stat of 10 times faster?
Yeah, so those are averages that we take from the candidates in our apps. Speaking with the companies, looking at data from the app to see, you know, how fast people are getting hired on average, comparing that to traditional methods. You know, I think there are crazy averages out there for, you know, me applying on, say, Indeed or, you know, on a company website. It can be up to 2 months, you know, to get hired. So we have so many candidates that get on our app.
And, hold up, Liam. Job seekers, tell me how long y'all been searching. Tell me in the chat how many months. Just put the number. How many months have you been searching? Because it could take a lot longer than that. We had somebody was 28 months. Woo-hoo!
That's what we're trying to fix with Hirect.
Yes, yeah, let's fix it, man. We got to get these people back to their cash flow.
Good.
Could you imagine, Liam? Imagine you were searching for 28 months. How much like mental, like you just. Oh man, it just hurt. It'll kill you. I mean,
I've got respect for whoever that is. I mean, it's tough. You know, every single time you get a rejection or you get ghosted, it's like, you know, it's tough. So I have a lot of respect for, you know, for whoever that is, and hopefully Hirect can get them the next job.
Well, let's talk about that real quick. I want to give some quick shout outs because we got a few more minutes in here, and then we got some giveaways we want to do. So here's some shout outs. Okay, you heard Liam say it. And I'm going to say it, and I'm sure everybody here will say it. I got mad respect for all of y'all. Okay, Paul Haggerty, mad respect for you, brother. 18 months, mad respect.
Wow.
You know, it takes a lot. It takes a lot. And but you know what? Diamonds are forged under pressure, okay? So you're going through a refining season right now, Paul, right? And you're going to come out sharper. You're going to come out a stronger version of yourself. So I just want you to know that. And that's why I have so much mad respect for all of you guys. You know, Cat O'Toole, 10 months. William, 7 years. Dear Lord, William, we love you, brother.
Dean, Gregory, 30 months.
Jeff, 5 months. You know, Dean, 2.5 years. 32 months, Philip, right? Guys, we love you. I mean, seriously. Matter of fact, we got some giveaways. And just looking at these comments, I think what I want to do, and I didn't really think about this prior, but I think we're going to give we're going to do the giveaways to the longest time.
Yeah.
The longest time.
Yeah.
So here's what we're going to do. William McLaughlin, okay, congratulations to you. And a big special thank you to William. William is actually giving out some literal cash flow, y'all. Literal cash flow in the form of a Visa gift card valued at $250. William, congratulations, my friend. William.
Yep, congrats, William.
Congratulations, all right. And I saw also...
The next longest, I think, was it Philip?
Was it Philip Austin?
Was it? You know math better than I do. 2.5 years versus 32 months. Which one's longer?
It's close. So 2.5 years is 30. 32 is. 30.
All right, 32 longer. Months. Philip Austin, my friend, congratulations to you. Literally, Merry Christmas. $250. Man. And William, Liam, I'm sorry, you go by Liam. Liam, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. That means the world to us. I know it means the world to the audience. And for all of you that are going through it, listen, you're going to get there. Everybody does. You will get back to your cash flow.
There is not a person when I started this network that hasn't landed a job yet. Some we were wondering.
Yeah.
But it still happened. You will still, as you're active, you'll meet people and you will find that place. God will make sure that that happens.
Amen to that. Amen to that. All right, guys. So I want you to do me a favor. I'm going to pull this up in the screen right now, if you can pull this up. And I will actually put this link in the chat. This is to Hirect. You guys need to go download the mobile app, get it on your phone. up to 10 times quicker, 10 times faster, right? Hopefully this can, you know, solve your problems. And what I want you to do is I want you to give us your feedback. Please, please, please give us your feedback. And if we could pull up Liam in the screen real quick, I want everybody to take a big screenshot and tell Liam and Hirect, tag them, let them know how much you mean, they mean to us, and give them a warm welcome to the Who You Know community. And and thank you, Liam. Thank you so much for that.
Yeah, Liam.
That money, that cash flow, we all about that around here.
You know, it's holiday season. It's tough. Hopefully we can make a few people's, you know, holidays there.
Amen. Guys, that's the show.
Who's
it's
it about?
All about.
What's it about?
Who ya know. Merry Christmas, guys.
Merry Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho, ho.
Bye.
And about the room. I'm kidding.
Trevor Houston here, and I want to thank you for tuning in to the Who You Know Job Networking Show. We hope you've been inspired, encouraged, educated, and entertained all at the same time. For information on our different events, workshops, partners, or partnership opportunities available, check out whoyouknow.show for more details. And be on the lookout for our new mobile app coming soon. You never know how this show could help someone you know. You know? And if we've made an impact or put a smile on your face today, don't forget to hit that share button on your way out. Until next week, it's all about who you know. Bye!